something up here. Something big.
There's something big. Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Crysis, brought to you by these retarded alien things. I'll take the nuke. Is he trying to take it?
Nomad, the flight deck's overrun. We need to get off this ship. Hurry!
I'm bailing out, Nomad. I'm gonna grab a VTOL and get us airborne. We'll wait for you.
Can I go? I guess not.
Get out of here,
usually green means go, but I guess I go this way. Oh, he's got a minigun. I don't need it. I guess this place is useless for anything. Hey, what's up? This place is useless for anything but getting a bit more minigun ammo. I don't even like the minigun all that much. I don't even know why I have it. Alright, guess we'll go over here. Cool.
Get up here! These fuckers are swarming us!
Clear the bridge! Let's go! Let's go!
Admiral, there's a VTOL waiting on the flight deck. We have to go now!
I am not leaving this!
Get the door open! Get the
Nomad!
The fuck even happened? I completely fucked the game's dialogue and the fucking animations for shit. Oh my
Nomad.
God.
You have to save these people. Get out on deck. No.
Nomad, still alive?
Barely. The Admiral didn't make it. Where are you?
I'm with Helena in a VTOL. The carrier's overrun.
Everyone's either dead or jump ship.
Hold on, we're coming in to pick you up.
Probably I knew you were gonna say that because I already started machine gunning that in the thing. Oh, the one good thing that the minigun is for. You know, I wonder if I'm just not allowed to kill it. Hey, don't you throw VTOLs at me.
Son of a bitch!
We use our words. Fortunately, I don't really have anything that appears to be really effective against it. I guess I could use some more of these. I wouldn't mind having some of these. This is a much better option than what I was doing before, which was basically minigunning the fuck out of him. Which is what I learned was not actually quite as effective as anything. Hey, alright. I love the speed build, because I get these things out so fast. He's sort of close to the rocket launcher, though. My ammo supply. Don't be a dick. Come on. No, come on, kill him. Alright, here we go. Here we go again. It automatically puts me into armor mode whenever I do that, so it's annoying to reset it as well. I'm gonna step away from that. I wouldn't mind having that, a shotgun or something. Goss ammo, that works too. Oh. Not going into there. No siree, we'll not have any of that.
Leave me! Get out of here now!
Never gonna happen, mate!
a Reaper. That was the Reaper horn. This is like Super Mech Warrior. Oh. Damn it.
We're taking fire. I can't get near that thing.
Neither can I. So now we're taking them down once again. So it has these crappy turret things, which I hate.
Oh, shit! They brought out the big guns!
You know, these characters are...
Take out those cannons!
These characters are swearing more than I am. Jeez.
There must be a shield. Psycho, get us closer. Nomad, I'll transmit a signal for your suit. Okay, Psycho, bring her in as close as you can get.
Fire! I can't get near that thing.
Know what you're doing.
Even
Ditto.
Even his dialogue is
all
overlapping.
Right, keep it steady. Nomad, stand by. Hold on, I think it's working.
Shit! They're all over us. Nomad, keep them off our tail.
It's gonna be right here. No, I don't think I will be. Well, luckily, I saved, like, right here.
Hold on! I think it's working!
Shit, they're all over us! Nomad, keep them off our tail!
I always never liked this part. Can't lock on anything yet. Oh, fuck, stop freezing me! Oh, fuck, stop! I want none of that. Okay.
I got it! The shield's down!
Use the tank cannon! Wax that thing!
I'm doing that.
I thought you'd never ask.
Beautiful. That's one down.
Alright. Well, I kind of want to know where that kid was.
I'm working on the second one.
Only God knows where they're coming from. I really don't like these things. You know, they throw like a dozen at us, and those are the things that were apparently super scary that Prophet got eaten by.
Second shield's down.
Go on, mate. Take down that cannon.
No, I'm just gonna die in the fire. What? Nomad fell into fire? What a dumbass!
Second shield's down!
Dang. Go on, mate! Take down that cannon! Lock on with the tank gun!
Cool guys don't look at explosions.
Nice shooting.
Oh. What's up, big scary machine of death?
Oh, fuck! Hang on!
Fuck, I went down there again! They put that there on purpose!
Oh, fuck! Hang on!
No, actually, I just want to hear him say, oh, fuck again, because that's hilarious.
No, man, it's gonna sink us! Take that fucking thing down!
He says fuck a lot. So do I, though. So. Well, I hate these little robot things. I'm basically at the point where I can't really lay them down. Or maybe I can. Let's try it. Nope. I have
That's a
feeling.
Try to blast it open and see if you can fire a nuke in there.
Yeah, what's she say?
Nomad, blow open the hatch on the underside. Hurry, Nomad.
Yeah, I'm on it, believe me.
Okay, the
I'm on it. There's so much Michael Bay going on here, I cannot see shit. Oh, wait. Oh no, they're that way. Yeah. I'm trying to get off the carrier. Thank you very much.
Come on! Hurry! Come on! Jump! Jump! Come on! You can make it!
Hold on!
Come on, Psycho! Go! Go! Go!
Your tax dollars at work. Entire carrier gone to waste.
There's a naval fleet en route from Japan. They'll be here within the hour.
I'm setting course to intercept.
No. We know how to beat them now. We need to keep fighting.
I'm picking up a transmission.
What is it?
You ain't gonna believe this, mate. It's Prophet.
He's alive?
Head kicking by the sound of it. Looks like he's inside the sphere.
Lock onto his position. We're going back.
Well, that's the end of Crisis. So, I know what you're probably thinking. What's my pinging at on that? The last 3 hours is just like, what the fuck game am I playing? No, not even 3 hours. I think it was more like the last hour. I'm sorry. I'm thinking like 20-minute segments. Pretty much as soon as you enter the ship, it just goes downhill, and I don't even know why. It's like, we need to make some sort of conclusion to the game. Because they clearly developed to the first part, and it's like, okay, now we need to finish it. This is what they came up with, and it was bad. Such a great beginning to it too. The Koreans, they're so polished, the fighting of that and all that kind of stuff. And so, you know, this is kind of the last memory people have whenever they play this game, which is, you know, it's not good. Still, that was by 2007 standards. It's a lot better today, considering how low gameplay can sometimes get, it can get very bad and repetitive, so it feels a lot better today than it does back when you played it. And there's mods now and stuff too. Obviously, you know, I just want to get past that dumbass boss and all that kind of crap, like, just as fast as possible. Would I recommend it? Yes, because a good portion of the game is a hell of a lot of fun. You can do so much, you can have so much fun with it. It's something I always turn on whenever I get a nice computer upgrade. So, yeah. So they made after this Crisis Warhead, which also came with Crisis Wars, which was a multiplayer component that came with it. I've never really touched Crisis Wars much. I tried it a little bit and didn't really like it, so I just left it at that. Crisis Warhead I'll do at some point. I definitely enjoy that. It's basically this kind of same kind of game. You know, you fight the Koreans and stuff. I don't know. It seems like all the bad shit happened all at once. Like final boss, you know, like big ass enemies, and they threw those same guys who apparently abducted Prophet now die in two hits, and they're really easy to take down with the scars. So don't ask me. And something a little bit of an interesting fact, I actually have another Let's Play on YouTube of the same game under Tactical LP. If you do a search for Let's Play Crisis, you can probably find it. And I don't know. You know what? I don't know how it compares, but it feels a lot better. Mostly in the sense that I kind of did look. I kind of remember the boss and how to beat him. So there's that. This is actually 1080p. I attempted 1080p in that one, and I couldn't actually do it. This is when I did it for reals, and I successfully pulled it off too, with some mods too. So that's really nice. There's a big microphone quality difference. Like, you're not even gonna like this. The quality of the mic I have now is like way different from way back when. So that also makes a difference. I was actually doing my best not to repeat funny shit that happened necessarily in that one, because I'm just thinking to myself, I'm like, I'm not gonna fake it. I'm not gonna fake like these funny things that happened kind of thing. So in that sense, if you're looking for those moments, you still have to go back to that Let's Play, obviously. And I do feel I've created a couple of new good moments, because every time you start up the game, always something different happens, and I enjoyed it. The other thing that's a lot different about this playthrough is it has my new kind of demeanor when it comes to doing Let's Plays. Like, I don't really I talk over the dialogue or like scripted sequences or cutscenes or whatever very little. Only when there's like, you know, there's like no talking or whatever. But I still think I don't add a whole lot, so I don't really say it a whole lot. The other thing is I was cutting out loading screens, if you noticed. That's kind of my thing now. I thought it was great. It just transitions right into the gameplay. If you're watching it like a motion picture, then I think it's fantastic. And the other thing was what was I gonna say? I don't know. It's I tried a lot harder with my. I think the gameplay is fucking so much better than the last one, because I mastered that little thing where I just sprint for a second, then jump, and then punch shit. And I did it for a lot longer this time, because I just mastered the art of that, and it was a lot of fun to do, actually. A lot of fun to show you guys, and I had a lot of fun doing that. Fun, I know. I don't know. It's this is not really a story-driven game, and if you ever saw Crisis 2, you just kind of load that up, and you're like, what the fuck were they even thinking? They completely... Basically, the whole thing around this was, apparently this didn't sell well, and, you know, you can kind of see why. It was like a really high graphical game at the time. The ending was crap, and so the piracy rate was really high, and people would just beat in this, you know, they'd be left off with a crappy multiplayer component, and, a crappy ending, so they're like, okay, I'm not buying this shit. Admittedly, yeah, you know, that does happen. You know, you kind of, you have such a great beginning, and then you don't do a great conclusion to it, so. You know, I doubt very much that a lot of people actually ran this game, way back in the day. Now it's pretty good for that. But they were bitching a whole lot about the PC piracy, and they're like, okay, we're switching your development to consoles, because clearly, the PC guys don't want it. And as far as I know, the console guys don't even care about this. This is like, I don't know. It's not something like, oh man, Crisis 2 is coming out. No, they're worried about Call of Duty and Halo and shit. Whenever a new Crisis game comes out, it's that kind of thing that you get, you know, like it's kind of like a present under your tree, and it's kind of like, oh, you bought me Crisis, huh? You bought me Crisis 3. Okay, thanks, mom or dad. I don't know. But yeah, so they were bought out by EA like ages. I don't know exactly, but they have a really strong relationship with EA, and so that's pretty much probably why they went in that direction. So now they don't really seek to make really good engines. They just kind of seek to make really good engines that work within the standards of the Xbox or PS3 or whatever the fucking next generation console is. I don't really care about. So the thing is, it kind of waters it down from an amazing looking engine and game to basically, oh look, it's another developer trying to make like Frostbite engine or some other shit that's unimpressive. I'm sorry, I'm not impressed by any of those engines. Like this game back in the day fucking impressed me so much. Now I'm not impressed so much. And there hasn't really been any engines that really impressed me. Unreal Engine, don't care. Source Engine did a couple of nice things. The Crytek engine is sometimes okay. I don't know. It's one of those things. You know, I'm starting to wonder if this is actually looping right now. I'm gonna assume it is, so. So I hope you enjoyed my little playthrough of this, and I guess I will see you for Warhead whenever I do that, and whatever I do next. So I hope you guys all have a very safe and happy holidays, and I'll be seeing you later. Bye.